Today, I have some tips for you so that you can create your own professional Photoshop actions. You will see how you can make your actions pop up a dialog to make adjustments, as well as messages to let you know how to run your actions. First, we're going to take a look at what actions are and how to use them. On your menu bar, up here, there is an icon for actions. And if you don't see that icon, you can come up here to Window and click on Actions. And now we have our actions and each step that the action is actually taking. So Photoshop actions are an easy way to turn complex, multi-step edits into a one-click process. Actions record your exact steps and allow you to replay them to repeat the same edit across multiple photos. So that's what actions are. Let's see how we use them. In Photoshop, there are a set of actions that come with Photoshop. They're called default actions, but you can get actions on many websites. You may have to pay for them. Some may be free, but I'm going to show you how to load in one of those actions. So I come up here to Menu, and there's something called Load Actions. And so on your computer, you're going to find a file with a .atn extension that is your Photoshop actions file. Just say open, and that loaded my action. In my case, it says Photoshop Actions Demo. So in the Actions panel, let's start off with an action that is supplied by Photoshop. In the Actions panel, usually an action is created in a folder. And under the default Actions folder, there are actions themselves. Let's choose Wood Frame. And if you twirl this arrow down, you see all the steps that this action is actually going to take, all the different edits. So if you highlight the action name and come down here to hit play selection. In this case, we have a dialog that pops up. Of course, our image is already 100 pixels wide and tall, more than that, and say continue. So this action did what it was supposed to do. It created a wood frame around this image. Besides being able to see the steps that the action is taking, you can actually go into history and see the names of the steps in the history panel. And if you're familiar with the history panel, you know that you can click in the history panel at different points to step back or go forward in the process. And if you want to start all over again and run a different action or run this action again, no need to delete everything out of the history panel. Just go to the very top and select that step. Let's create a simple action. First, I'm going to delete this action on the bottom that I had added earlier. And to delete an action, all you need to do is highlight the action name and click on the trash can. And now to create an action, you start with creating a new set, which is this folder icon right here. Click on that and give your set a new name. Now you have a new set. Underneath, you need to create your actions. Here's the create new action icon. Click on that. Give your new action a name. We're going to call this floor cleanup. And this new action is in the Photoshop actions demo set. And you can attach function keys to it and give the action colors. I'm just going to click on record. So once I've clicked on record, Photoshop is going to record the steps that I'm doing into my action. So I'm going to duplicate this background layer with Command-J. As you can see, that step was recorded. I'm going to come up to the top and click on Filter, Noise, and Median. I'm going to choose a value of 30 and click OK. I'm going to hold down my Alt key and click on the Add New Layer Mask icon. I'm going to select that layer mask and hit a D, and that resets the swatches on the left-hand side of the toolbar, where white is now my foreground color and black is my background color. Then I'm going to stop the recording with this square icon right here. Now I need to test my new action. I'm going to click on the history panel and click on the very top of the history panel. So that put me back to the beginning as if I just opened up the file. Come back to the actions panel, highlight my floor cleanup action, and click play selection. And now to work with this action, all I need to do is click on my layer mask, use my brush, and clean up my background. And that's going to take care of most of the dirt or spots on the background. We'll refine this in a second. And if I want to add to this action or edit it, what I would do is click on the last step that I was on, then click the record button. And in this case, I just want to add a new layer. So shift option command in, there's a new layer. And if that's all I wanted to do, I could say stop recording. And say if I want to use my clone stamp on this layer to get these extra spots off of this background paper back here, I can press S or the clone stamp tool, sample, and paint that away. So this is a good use of an action. Say you have a photo shoot where you had a lot of images where you needed to clean up the background paper on the floor, and you need to do this to every image. You would just come up here to your actions panel, click on your action, and you wouldn't manually have to repeat every step when you first open an image to edit it. If you're getting value out of this so far, hit that like button. Here's another tip. If you make a mistake while you're recording your action, hit stop, then go back and delete the incorrect step, select the last correct step that you were on, and hit record again. So now we're gonna make an action that is a little bit more complex. And I'll show you a possible situation that you can run into and how we can overcome that and make this action flexible. Under my set Photoshop actions demo, I'm going to create a new action, and I'm just going to call it sharpen and say record. Since I'm going to sharpen this image, what I want to do first is resize it, then apply the sharpening, and we're going to use high pass. So I'm going to come up here to image size, and I'm just going to type in 1080 for the width and say okay. Now I'm going to add a new layer, shift option command in, and add a stamped visible layer, shift option command E. I'm going to desaturate this image with shift command U, and I want to change the blend mode to something like overlay, and maybe change the opacity. But the thing is, in this case, every time I change the opacity, it's recording it, and I don't want that. That kind of messes things up. So here's another tip. First of all, we're going to stop the recording, click the step that's the error, and in this case, I have multiple steps, so I'm going to click Shift and select all of my steps that I need to delete. I've deleted them. I had to put my blending mode back to normal, my opacity to 100, and I'm back on my desaturate step. Now click Begin Recording. If I double click on layer 7, I bring up the layer style. Now here's where I have a little bit more freedom. I can change anything in here. I can change my blend modes. I can see my preview. I do want this on overlay. And see, this time if I want to change my opacity or anything, it's not recording it. And I do want the opacity at 100. At this point, I'm gonna say okay. And then I can come up here to filter, other, high pass. And I'm gonna bring this down just a little bit of sharpening. I'm going to say 1.1 for now and say okay and click stop. So here's another tip. Anytime you're recording your steps and you see things changing, like for instance opacity or any kind of adjustment by you making those slight changes, you want to find another way to make that happen. And in this case, double clicking on that top layer to bring up the layer style, we were able to make those changes. Anything in that layer style, the opacity, blending modes, and it doesn't affect the recording until you say okay. So look for those opportunities to use a dialog to make changes. Again, because you have the dialog box open, it doesn't register those changes until you say okay. So now it's time to test my action. So if I go to my history panel, go all the way up to the top, and come back to my action, highlight it, click on my play selection, resized my image, and it sharpened it. Here is all of the steps that we recorded in the action. Resize image, new layer, stamp visible, desaturate, all the things we did. Now let's make this action versatile. You saw how we chose the radius in the high pass filter. Well, this action, every time you run it, it's that same radius. We want a way to make it flexible. In our action, we're going to come down to where it says high pass. And right next to the high pass step that we recorded is something called toggle dialog on off. Click that. We're going to rerun the action again. I'm gonna click on sharpen, click play. It's resizing the image. The high pass dialog comes up again. We can change our radius. I'll change this to 1.2 this time and say, okay. So now we've made it more flexible. The main tip here is if you're using a filter, like in this case, the high pass filter, and you want to make the dialog come up every time you run it so that you can make it flexible and make a different adjustment every time you run your action, right next to the high pass step, click this box right here, which will toggle on that dialog. So it'll pop up, you can make your adjustment, and then continue. So let's create another action. And this time we're gonna run into another situation. So I'm gonna come up to my same action set, click on new action, and name cutout subject and say record. I say Command J, duplicate the background layer. And I'm going to select one of my selection tools up here because I want the select subject button at the top. I'm going to click on that. And now I'm going to click on the add new layer mask icon at the bottom of the layers panel. And now I'm going to create a solid color adjustment layer. And I'm going to choose a color and say OK. I'm going to move it below my layer one, which is the subject layer. And I'm going to say, stop recording. I want to test this. And I'm going to go to the top of my history panel and come to my new action called cutout subject and say play. So as far as creating a helpful action, this is like a starting point. If you wanted to cut somebody out of their background and using it in a composite, I could still go in here and refine my selection. So it's a starting point for something like that. There's a possible problem here. When I was recording right here at this point, right after I made the fill layer and I clicked on it and moved it below the subject layer, it had this name here, layer one. What if there's another situation where there is no layer one? So basically it was dependent on there being a layer one and me moving it that way. We want to get away from that. We want to make our recordings of steps we're doing non-specific. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete this step, move current layer. And I want my history to be back at the start too. I'm going to hit record again. And now I'm going to press command and left open bracket. And so that moved that layer down. And notice the language it used. It says move current layer to previous layer. It didn't name a specific layer like layer one. Now I want to add another layer on top of the layer one, which is the subject layer. But if I click into it, you saw that it recorded select layer one. That's something else we want to get away from. So there's another way to do that, which makes it non-specific. In other words, it's not selecting a layer by name. So I'm going to stop the recording. I'm going to delete my mistake. Say OK. I'm going to put this down where it was. I'm going to press record. And this time I'm going to press the Alt and my left open bracket. And it says select forward layer. So it didn't say select a specific layer by name. It just said select forward layer. And now it's going to make another layer. Shift Option Command N. And then I was going to clip it to my layer below, Option Command G. And so now I'm ready to stop my recording. And let's test this again. Back to the beginning in history, highlight my action, press play. And so now I have a good start to cutting somebody out of the background. So if I knew this was a project where I'm doing a lot of this, I can create this action. I can click on my layer mask, go into select and mask, and refine my selection. I can use this layer up here to do some more retouching or refining. So the main goal here was not to click around on your layer panel. Use your keyboard shortcuts to move your selections up and down. Another tip to make your actions more flexible and give the person who's running the action some indication of what's going to happen or instructions they need to complete the action correctly when running it. So here, this step, right before it makes the color fill layer, I'm going to my menu and say insert stop, and I say change fill color. And I'm going to make sure allow continue is checked and say okay, and automatically toggle this dialog. And I want it to toggle the color fill adjustment layer. So I'm going to come up here to the top of my action and select it and say play. So it created a Photoshop dialog to ask me to change fill color. I'll say continue. Here's my color fill layer. I can name it. And now I can change the color and say okay. All in trying to make this flexible, pop up these dialogs to alert the person who's running the action. There's something coming up. They can make a choice to stop or continue, and they can make an adjustment. If you want to know more about Photoshop, click or tap on one of the videos on the screen now. If you haven't already, subscribe, like, and share this video. Thanks for watching. And remember, it's never too late to learn. See you in the next video.